Okay student, today we will discuss concept of the database design or database model. Database design represents the logical structure of the database. It is the process of creating the logical representation of the structure of the database. It should be representing logically. Why we need the concept of the database design? The main objective of the database design is to identify the fact that need to store in a database. How, what are the different data elements, how they are connected with each other, what are the different association among the different data elements. That is a database design. So we see that logical structure of the database, that is called, that concept is called database design. Now when we see that database designs, database design is created using our data model, and in data modeling we are having the different users and analysts are involved. So whenever we have to create the model for the any database, we need different users like developers and users. We need database administrators. We are having the different types of the group of the users are there. So data model for that one, we need all of those users. We have to think about all of those users in the data modeling. Now what is a data model? Data model is a set of tools that are used to develop a database designs. Different tools are used for the database designs development. Thus data model is used to develop database designs, and it is a graphical representation. A graphical system used to capture the nature and relationship among the data. I already say that what are the different data elements are there. To represent all of those data elements, we say that here we are having the different data elements are there, like students are there, teachers are there, how they are connected with each other. So when we say that we are having the graphical system used to capture the nature and the relationship among the data. When we see that we are having the student is there, so what are the nature of the students? We see that student ID, student name, student address, what other information. Here we are having the teachers, so teacher names, teacher ID, teacher names, and other information related to the teachers, right? So what we have, we see that data model is set of tools that are used to design a data model. And that is a graphical use to capture the nature and association among the data. When we see that we are having data models defines how the data elements are connected with each other, how they proceed, and then how the data stores inside the system. Here we are having the associations among them. So these students are connected with the teachers. It's been teachers teach students. Students are enrolled with the teacher, right? Teacher supervise students. So these, how the elements are connected with each other, how they proceed, and how the data stores in a system. That is the data model. Data model defines how the logical structure of the database is modeled. Data models are the fundamental entity to introduce the abstraction of the DBMS, database management systems. No, it introduces the abstraction of the DBMS. What is the basic structure of the DBMS? That hide the basic structures. What is going on the DBMS? Data model provide the abstraction in a DBMS. Data models are created at different levels, like we are having the enterprise levels, and similarly we are having the project levels. Within one organization, if we are having the different projects are there for different projects, we may have the graphical system that is used to capture the nature and the relationship among the data. While same for the organizations, if we are having large organization is available, different users are there. User have to perform the different entity, and set of the projects are available in an organization. Then we have to use the concept of the enterprise levels. So data model can be used for the enterprise level, overall the organization level. Let me say that Comsat University is there. So for complete Comsat organizations, we may have the graphical systems to capture the overall the natures and the relationship among the data elements. And similarly, same over here, we are having the small modules like small section, exam sections, admission sections. So for that one, we may have the project level. Data models organize data for different users. We may have the different users are there, and we have to organize data based on the requirement of the users. And every TBMS is based on the data models. We are having different data models are there, and every data model based as every DBMS based on the data model. Let we are having the relational data models. On this one, relational data model, different DBMS are based, like Oracle, we said SQL Server, MySQL. Similarly, we already discussed some data models like hierarchical data model. On that one, IMS, Information Management System, DBMS, is based on the hierarchical data model. Then IDS, and so on. We are having the three main component of the data model. First one, we see that we are having the structure part, manipulation part, and the integrity constraints. When we see that different component structure part, how the data model is implemented, what are the main component of that data model? Let me say relational data model, we see that we are having the table containing rows and columns. That is the structure of the relational data model. If we are having network data model, it has its own structure. Hierarchical data model, it has its own structure. Objective oriented data model, that data model have its own structure. So every data models have its own structure. Let we see that relation data model is very common nowadays. So we see that structure of the relational data model is a table that contains the rows and column. That is the basic structure. Manipulation part, when we see that different DBMS are there or different data models are there, different powerful operation user may be able to perform. What are those powerful operations? Like insertion to add the data, updation to make change in the data, or deletion to remove data from our database. And last one component, that is the integrity constraint. Integrity constraint, these are the set of the rules to maintain the correctness and accuracy of the data, while no one may be able to violate those rules. How to maintain the correctness and accuracy? Let me say, we say that we are having one rule that student marks, basic GRE marks must be greater than 3.5 300, then student may be able to enroll in university. So that is one rule. If candidate marks are less than 300, then no one may be able to violate that one rule. Student ID, value of that one must be unique. That will not be repeated. So that is another integrity rules. So integrity means accuracy, correctness. So constraint set of rules. No one may be able to violate those rules. Now, when we are having the different component of data models, now we are having the types of the data models. We are having the different data models are there. First one, we are having the semantic data model. Next one, record-based data model. Last one, we are having the physical data model. When we say semantic data models, which provide more tool, it's only deal at the external level and the conceptual level, right? And three level architecture, we are having different levels are there: external level, conceptual level, and internal level. So semantic data model works only at external level and conceptual level. At the internal level, semantic data model doesn't work. Types of the semantic data models, we are having the different types. We will discuss these in detail. We are having the object-based data models, and next one, we are having the entity relationship data model. We are having the object-oriented concepts over here, and object-based data models and entity relationship data models. We are having the entity relationship diagrams concept will be used for these ones. ERD. We will discuss these things in complete details. Now we are having another record-based data model. The database contains, our database consists of the number of fixed format records, and each record type having the fixed number of the field. We said it, number of the fixed format record. Fixed format records means we are having different records are available in the record-based data models, and the format of that one record is very fixed. Very fixed means we are having the different types of the fields are available and having the fixed number of the fields. And let me say that one record-based data model is here. We are having the fixed number of fields 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. For all records, must have to follow the 5 fields. And the fixed format of the records. Fixed format of the records, let we are having one column is there, so data types of this ones. That is the fixed. Let here ID is available, so all the ID value must be in integer. Let me suppose. All the value must be in integers. Then name is here, so name value must be in the character form. So what is record based data model? That is the number of the fixed format record, and each record types having the fixed number of the field. We are having the different type of the record based data model. First one, we are having the relation data model, network data model, and hierarchical data models. If we see that we are having the concept of the relation data model, and relation data models, we are having, what is the structure of this one? We are having the tables that contain the rows and columns. Then data manipulation operations. What are the different components? We said it. We are having the different components. So first one was the structure. So what is the structure? We are here. We are having the tables that contains rows and columns. And relation data model was actually based on the mathematical relations. In mathematical relations, we are having the concept of the domain and range. While in relation data model, we are having the rows and columns. We will discuss relation data model in detail. This one contains the rows and columns. While in relation data model, we are having another component, data manipulation. So here user can perform insertion, insert, update, user can perform the different operation like insertion, insert the data, add the new data, update, make changes in the data, add the new record. If there is need to make any change in any value of any records, then user may be able to perform the update. And if user need to remove the record, let we say that any student is there, we want to remove the record of that one student, then for that one we are having the concept of the delete. So different data manipulation operation can be performed. And then different integrity constraints are there. And relation data model, what are those? Let me say that for uniqueness we are using the concept of the primary key. For connecting the different type of the table, we are having the concept of the foreign key. For other constraints, we can use the check constraints. For the require attribute, we must have a value. We are having the not null constraints, and other constraints are also available in the relational data model. Next one is the network data model. Network data models. In the history of the database architecture, we discuss about database task group. Network data model is also called database task group. In network data model, data is stored in the form of record. Each record consists of a group of the related data values. Now, each record can have a several child, and each child record can have more than one parent record. So we are having the relationship among the different record, that is many to many. We say that each record can have several child, and each child record can have many more than one parent. So we are having the many to many relationship among the different record. The example of this one is IDS, IDS database architecture, that is based on the network data model. If here we are having customer and loan, we are having the different customer records are available. Customer record 1, 2, 3, and 4. Customer 1 avail two different loans, L1 and L2. Customer 2 avail only one bill. Let loan 3, that is availed by the customer 2 as well as customer 3, 2 and 3. So we are having, for each customer we are having the many loan, and for each loans we may have the different more than one customers. So we are having one to one, one to many, or many to many relationship can be there in network data model. Now when we see that we are having the network data model, here we are having, when we see that we are having the parent record, that is called the owner, child record, that is called the member. It's both one to one, one to many, many to many relationship. Similarly, it also support the recursive relationship with itself. Let we are having the one employee is available, each employee can manage other employee, so we may have the recursive relationship with itself. Now we are having the few drawbacks of the network data model. From its structure, it's very clear. It is very complex to understand and develop. Currently, we are having the customers and loan. If we expand this one to whole of the organization, it become very complex. And second one, structure must be defined in advance, which is very difficult. If we have to make change in the structure, we have to start working from the scratch. That was the network data model. Now next one is the hierarchical data model. In hierarchical data model, For the data structure point of view, we are having the two different concepts. First one is the records, and second one is the parent-child relationships. The record is the collection of the fields that provides information on an entity or a relationship instance. So collection of the field value, that is the record, which provides information on the entity or the relationship instance. When we see that we are having the parent is there and child is available, so in the parent child we are having the parent child relationship PCR, and that is one to many relationship. We are having the tree like structure, one parent is available having the different child, one to many relationship, while each child belongs to only one parent. Tree-like structure that support one-to-one and one-to-many relationship. Example of this one is IMS, Information Management Systems, that is based on the hierarchical data model. Another popular hierarchical DBMS that was MRI System 2000. In hierarchical data models, very high level record that is called parent, and then parent that is at the topmost high level record is called the parent, and then further have the different child. If we are having the parent is at the topmost, then that parent is called the that we see that here we are having the different set of the records are there. If we check, this one is called the parent, this one is the high level records that we see that 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Here if we check, record 2 is at the high levels, then the record 4 and 5. So record 2 is considered the parent of 4 and 5. While 1 is at the topmost positions, this one is called the root. Top parent at the topmost position, that is called and the lower level records is called the child. So here we are having the two different child of the roots, that is the 2 and 3. Child of the 1 is 2 and 3, child of the 2 is 4 and 5. And parent may have more than one child, but child can have more than, cannot have more than one parent. Parent have many child, one child, one to many child. But one child belongs to only one parent. It support one to many relationship, one to one relationship. Let 3 is having only one child. That is a 6. One to one relationship, one to many relationship, but it doesn't support many to many relationship. And it also can't support the recursive relationship, relationship with itself. We are having the some advantage of the this one, that is flexible for changing the structure. If we have to make the change in the structure, we can easily make the change in the structure. While in network data model, that was not flexible. That is very hard. That is very difficult to change in the structure. Insertion, updation, deletion, that is very easy. Different DML, data manipulation, operation or data manipulation languages, are very easy and very little skills are required to develop these one systems. To accessing the data or updating the data, to retrieve the information, to make any modification in the data, that is very fast. While we are having some drawback of this one, that is we don't have any concept of the many to many relationship. Adding the new records to a database need to redefine the whole system. So it's all about the three level architecture. Main drawback of this one is we don't have the concept of the many to many relationship and hierarchical data model. Okay, thanks for watching the video. Have a nice time.